Mingjian uses Rust to enhance some database apps' performance as he breaks apart the state of the art to make hash tables and B-trees dance.
But you can, I hope, to leave more time to ask questions, or if not, you can reread this presentation or join the communicate. Okay, related work, you may compare some project work with TensorBase. One is in Rust, it's called Data Fusion, which is use Apache Arrow to construct a in-memory data query engine. The problem of it is still a traditional design, so which is far from performance oriented here. Okay, there are another paper named How to Architecture a Query Compiler Request, which has a few standard arc results and inspires TensorBase. The problem is it's a paper only. Okay, there are another project named Weird, which use a dedicated Weird IR for dates. The problem of Weird is it has abstract overhead and a deep bounding to the ARVM API. Here, okay, is an architecture of TensorBase. It's like the count graph of language systems, that, like Rust C. So I will back soon for this, because this hour is a Rust festival. So I will talk more little about Rust. Here, okay, Rust is great. So TensorBase benefits from various aspects of Rust ecosystem. One thing I want to say is TensorBase is a one-person project just in several months. So without hype of engineering Rust, this cannot be achieved. Okay, in the TensorBase, we decide the performance in the core. Then we do a modularization as possible. Then we hope to keep it stupid simple, so it's highly hackable. For Cargo is a kernel feature in Rust, so just everyone we should familiarize the tooling. Okay, it's just some quick, which is quick. Okay, procedure macro, which is a great feature in Rust also, but it has its own problem. So here is we just see. What I suggest is we use the lightly as possible. Okay, you can use the lightly build feature like particle micro diagnostic or micro span for byte debugging output, which is important here. We want to show you where you can see from the source of TensorBase. Syninterrupt is an other feature having used TensorBase. Thanks to the zero head of Syninterrupt, but it has own problem. For example, resource management or the error handling. We just say you met something, but for the time limit, we'll skip. Okay. For current is a great slide with fairless concurrence in Rust, right? Okay. It's nice for shared lasting safe thread safety in Rust, but maybe it's a little awkward when memory sharing needed. Now, memory reason, memory sharing needed. Here we list some. The main reason is Rust lacks the memory model like Java and say. Here is an example, but we may do a quick look. Okay. The person is if we want to imply the singleton net handler in like in Java or C++, we may need the lazy lock, which in fact can be avoided if we have a memory model to establish happens before relationship between the change and between the write and the read. Okay. I think wait is just another feature which is not used the tensor base. We just a little talk is the stair is also orthogonal to the performance. So use it correctly, you help to performance, but not correctly, you may harm to performance. Okay. Lifetime is another engineering excellent in Rust, but maybe make code complex. Okay. So what I always recommend is to dance with lifetime rather than to evade, because for a high performance system, you need to think carefully about resources manager. But if you want alternatives, level two way tensor base use, you may can consider. One is called Arena Locker. The other is unsafe calling to say. Sorry, we may a little quick for. If I have a problem with your bike. For this graph, what I want to, interesting one to point is the kernel in tensor base is a safe organized component which will have interact to the Rust, whole Rust system. Okay. Input is just a plain circle which passed into parse tree. In this step, we do lex validation. Then it transforms to the AST, will transform IR, which the IR is laid like the Rust C. The main reason is we want to reuse more than low level compilation infrastructure as possible. The high level IR, HIR, is made for handling data-related optimizations. In this phase, we will do semantic validation, and we will also do relational algebra. Okay, but I want to point some relational algebras can be optimized by low-level compiler, which loads necessary in high level IR. One unique and interesting characteristics of tensor base is we have a unified relational algebra operators. You may say in the traditional textbooks there are many relational algebra operators, but here we just unified into four operators. They are MIPE, union, join, short, and they have own shortcut. Here is a pretty print IR. You can clearly see how the IR can get transformer from the top circle query. Okay. The core idea here is I call the C of Pipers, which unify the date and the control follow dependence in the graph of Pipers. What's Pipers? Pipers just operate fused computing and data units. Here is just a Piper. So you may hear in textbook there are Volcano model. It is a operate live model, which is low FSR here. We discussed in TensorBase. So we don't, there are a lot more approval approach there to discuss. So a lot more data center or control center. We just depend what we want to review to gauge. Okay, low level IR. RIR is just for platform related optimization. For example, multi-cores or code gene. Okay. We have parallelism relation representation for multi-cores. TensorBase enables parallelism patterns. For example, map reduce for join rather than the general DAG schedule way like your popular engine. We will talk more about the schedule. For code short gene, we have a linearism representation, which is just a protocol template. We just provide here, okay, provide a human read the mechanical to enable you run and debug and write the in an elegant way to IR. Okay, this is data structure in late IR. Okay, now we come to the execution layer. The core of execution layer is just a decentralized safe scheduling JIT completion based kernel. Okay. Okay, we're back to talk the schedule. Compare with the popular synthesized schedule, we use a decentralized. There are two problems for synthesized schedule. One is it's a single point. Single point has a single point failure, and single point limited scalability. Okay. The second, in fact, in a lightning fast query, we have no time budget for you to initial a synthesized role for coordination. Okay. Why JIT completion? Because we want to top performance way back soon here. The engine just a C-Lang based JIT compiler, which you may compare with the popular RMMIR based JIT. Why C? Because C can run on almost everything, CPU, GPU, FPGA, something else. And it's human debuggable and it's highly hackable, okay. And it's fast enough completion for OLAP, okay. Okay, here is a TensorBase generator kernel. You can compare with the source from kernel source from paper. Okay, you will see here we have some magical string, a magical member here. Max screen is just the data partition location. The magical number is just the number of the hardware concurrence in concurrent socket. So the JIT completion, the advantage of JIT completion is we can embed the runtime information in the code, which will help more optimization for compiler, which cannot be done AOT completion. Okay, here. Okay, benchmark time. There are 2 milli information here. So we just get a simple summary here. You can see it later. Okay. Here we tensor base can do the query, end-to-end query, in the 6 times to 10 times faster than the same query in ClickHouse, which is a C++ or OLAP data warehouse or database. Point. Let's do a little point here. First, Rust is lightning fast, even unturned. Because the time limit, I have no to turn the concurrent compilation system. Second, C-based JIT compilation is lightning fast even unturned. And third, C-based JIT compilation is much faster than C++ and Rust even unturned. C-based JIT compilation is quite enough for a lab we can done in mere second, tens of mere second. Okay. For this, I present a simple math. It in fact for the simple sum aggregation query, it which you can just saturate the memory bandwidth of the benchmark platform with 1 gigabit per second memory bandwidth, because and forced, and we know it cannot be even fast, because this is already memory bound. So we just need the tens of the 60 milliseconds to scan over the memory. So we just, when we scan over the memory, we do the summing, then we get the results. So we, here is just, you can say the sleep. Here is just that we can turn the query to the tight loop in the kernel. Finally, it's vectorized by the compiler, okay. Once query for tensor-based fast compilation is we do partition compilation, which makes the completion time is correlated to the set hard kernel rather than to the total set of execution code. Okay. One other I want to mention here is the overhead of RVM compilation. In fact, is a little high, so the speed does not come for free here. Okay, few insights. I want to print some direction where the tensor base involved. One is storage layer. We will have our own storage layer, because popular storage and the computer separation is generally nice, I find sure. Second, optimization. Our goal is forced to make queries which cannot be optimized fastest here. And two, I hope to we may not use the popular CBO. What we want is a data driving low entry interface here. Okay, it's a little new. Maybe we can talk about more in communicate execution engine. We will high with tiered C completion. Okay, maybe we want a faster code engine. In fact, C completion and interpretation can be done in microseconds. Okay, which we also consider alternative JIT compilation tools, for example, Rust. Here, the main problem is querying JIT backend. The querying life is a little slow, as my test and the notes mature. Okay, scheduling. Okay, we may have no enough time. We just leave some entry for you can think. Okay. if we can talk more, okay. We can have a benign distribution engineering, okay, here. Okay. The finally, the next version of TensorBase, which is in programs, we will have main operators on single table, which will have the first version of storage delay. The biggest difference to the current version is we are provide compatibility with the ClickHouse. They include the compatibility to the protocol and on this desktop storage. Okay. Now, in the next version of TensorBase, want to continue to demonstrate the sub B in complex aggregation, for example, group by. So the early results are promotion. You can compare to the ClickHouse. We based on the comparable to the ClickHouse match tree, we can get 6 to 8 times faster than light of ClickHouse. Okay. Finally, I do a recap. OpenStruggle Head is in fact everywhere, so we should carefully make trade-off between the truths. You want performance, you want the future. Sometimes you can alone some little performance degrade to achieve a failure or want more performance. Second is high performance program paradigm in Rust. In fact, we do not need to reject unsafe. If you can control unsafe in a bound scope. Okay. Finally, top performance OLAP is achieved with engineering Rust in TensorBase, and the work shown can be picked up from the open source project tensorbase.io. Okay, thanks. Okay, I do quite. Okay, any question? We do a quite slate because the content is too many, but the time is limited. Okay. Do we have some interesting question? Okay.
Okay. Jane, thanks. Okay. Thanks for the presentation. And okay. And we have a question from the chat. So which is are there any last paradigms that have been getting in the way for this project, or has it been basically all positive?
Okay, I see the question. Okay, where Rust paradigm. Okay, in fact, we have many use the Rust paradigm in the TensorBase. Expect my so-called high performance paradigm. We have some enable okay some low level concurrence we are mentioned. Okay, higher is this is how singleton. Okay, this is in fact it's not a singleton because we need a lock. Yes, it's some problem we can to improve in Rust. Okay. In my presentation we just may I present here is the problem we could put to improve in Rust. Okay, because for example, left-hand is a great idea concept, but sometimes when the compiler are not smart, which especially before the NRR, no local lifetime introduce, we have a strong the limit on the lifetime. So we have to sort many ways to concrete the problem we in, but in fact the communicator is continue to improve the lifetime the problem to more ecosystems. So sometimes you need note the workaround, but sometimes you may still can consider the workaround. For example, Arena, Anok, here, it's because sometimes we just not need the exact lifetime for us. So the Arena hyper, we just Anok the object as we want. When in the IR phase, when we get past the phase, we dispose the object with the allocator together at the end of the phase. So it's a nice pattern, high performance pattern for which can we don't lead to think much more lifetime problem, and we just get the high performance here. Okay, but basically my experience from Rust is positive here, in fact. So with the engineering Rust hype, I the tooling, the semantic, the language here we mentioned here, but you can find more on the open source repo to get the source to get more exact the information. Yeah, in fact. Okay.
Okay, thanks for answering. And so we are running out of time for this session. Well, thanks again for the great presentation about the TensorBase. Okay. Thank you.